When I started working on this ocean, I started teaching myself how to do a staggered animation with CSS with these bubbles, but I quickly discovered that there was something very uniform and not natural about having a loop where you're just saying like, hey, maybe there's a 1 second delay between when each of these animations happen on these bubbles. And so I was like, oh, I wonder if there's like something in Sass where you can just introduce a little bit of randomness. And your code can be clean because you're not actually just coming up with random numbers. So you can see that it's just a random number, but you're also not doing very uniform delays. And that's actually what's going on here. I can switch back to my code. Oops, that's not what I want. And I have this bubble class where I have written this loop that goes through and adds animation delays to each element in the scene that has a class of bubble. And it adds a delay that you would expect of like, you know, it basically increases, the delay increases by 1 second for each nth child. So like the third, you know, the third bubble is gonna have a delay of like 3 seconds. But then we're also doing some fun Sass random math where I'm asking, Sass random is gonna let you define a range for your random number. And it's typically one to another number. And I really wanted it to be between 0 and 1 because I didn't want there to be huge differences in the delays. So I wrote random 10 and then times it by 0.1 and then I'm adding our necessary syntax of it has to be, I want it to be in seconds. I think it gives this just like nice sort of organic feel without actually being a complicated solution.